Fisher, it's time we talked about the Ark.
What is it?
What Nikoladze wants most in the world and what we're going to catch him by.
That's all we know.
We know the Ark is hidden somewhere inside the Georgian presidential palace. And we know Varlam Kristavi is letting him take it.
Who's Kristavi?
The new president of Georgia, pushed into power by our friends at the CIA.
It doesn't make sense.
We'll do the thinking. Your primary mission in Georgia will be Nikoladze. We get him and the game's over. The good guys win.
Were you talking to Lambert?
Yeah. How soon before we touch down in Georgia?
We don't. You'll be making a halo jump.
Goody.
Dad, is that you?
Sarah, it's good to hear your voice.
Are you coming home? The TV said you guys beat Nikoladze.
It's not that simple.
So you're not coming home?
No, honey, not yet. But soon.
A collective sigh of relief as the U.S. returned to a state of amicable diplomacy with China. The swift action of the CIA and Chinese intelligence revealed a splinter faction of the Chinese military covertly supporting the Georgian information crisis. Declaring a national day of mourning for those lost in the Georgian information crisis. Confirms the consummate defeat of Combain Nikoladze's cyber warriors. The acts of information terrorism have come to an end. And in a ceremony later today, President Bowers will be issuing an official thanks to the CIA, FBI, and U.S. Special Forces for their role in bringing an end to the crisis. Though his whereabouts are still unknown, Combain Nikoladze is essentially powerless.
We have torn off the Scorpion's claws. We have severed his tail. And he cannot stay hidden for long.
Georgian Presidential Palace, Tbilisi, Georgia, November 13th, 2004, 0004 hours. Find Combain Nikoladze and the Ark. Combain Nikoladze has returned to Georgian Presidential Palace in order to retrieve a weapon known only as the Ark. The great risk involved in Nikoladze's personal return to Tbilisi suggests its enormous value. Any threat posed by Nikoladze or the Ark must be dealt with. So, greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to what is supposed to be the final mission in Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell in first-person perspective. However, of course, there are three bonus missions which I will be covering after this. For this mission itself, I'm hoping that we have fifth freedom so that we can kill, you know, whoever we want, because otherwise it's going to be a little difficult to sneak past certain areas of the game. But apart from that, like especially the starting area, but apart from that, what I really like about, you know, these earlier Tom Clancy titles is how they were true to the spirit of Tom Clancy in, you know, they never shied away from showing some of the more covert truths of the world, such as, you know, like secret agencies putting people to power to further their own political gains and things of that nature. Because, I mean, if something as scandalous as that gets out, then, I mean, the world democracy is already shaken to its core, and nobody really knows what to believe in anymore. But yeah, they don't shy away from showing things like that. And I really like that about the game. But I have prattled on for long enough, so let's go ahead and let's do this. That was a very low opening.
Welcome back to Georgia, Fisher. Our cleanest path to the Ark is President Kristavi's records. Details on your upset.
What if Kristavi gets in my way?
Don't touch him. He's copacetic with the CIA. If Kristavi dies, the mission's over.
Nothing about whether we can kill anybody or not, whether, you know, we have fifth freedom or not. But I'm hoping we do. I shall be testing it out very soon anyway. And I'm hoping there are no alarm requirements for this. The scenery looks amazing. And, well, I want to say this is a very, very low opening. I mean, if Fisher could get here, you might as well have just, you know, parachuted into that dude's house. But, oh well, whatever. Whatever works for this guy, I guess. Moving on, let me just go ahead and save you. So, as it turns out, Kristavi has been, you know, a mole inside the Georgian government, working for the CIA for a long time now. I think we also hear about this guy's name, CIA Agent Danahoe, in one of the later games, Tom Clancy games, but I cannot be sure. I feel like I've heard this name somewhere, maybe when I was reading this anyway. Promising to hold elections within a month, seven former ministers from the Nikoladze's cabinet opposed to Kristavi's rule vanish. Well, that's convenient, isn't it? Maybe CIA pawned the trooper by Georgia, so let's call him the CIA's puppet. Oh my god. We can assume the CIA had a heavy hand in the disappearance of those seven ministers on October 29th. I mean, they don't hold back at all, do they? Yeah. So this is where it gets tricky, because I need to do like a wall jump to get up there. And I don't know why, but I'm having a little bit of input lag, and I would really prefer it if I did not fall off this wall. And yeah, that's done. We've done it. Yeah, we need to like gently drop off the ledge. Yeah, you need to like gently lower yourself, because if you don't, then you're gonna fall to your death. Which, in my opinion, is sort of a dick move, but it is what it is. Isn't there any way like I can just jump onto this? Ah, yes, this works. Sam screaming. This is gonna be another tough one to pull off with this modern salt. You can never really gauge the direction. And we succeeded on the second try. So I'm guessing that's progress. But yeah, you never know. Just to be on the safer side. I mean, at least this way you can get like a more up close and personal experience of what it is like to be Sam doing his job, you know? I think from here I can drop down and grab that. Well, I could not. And that was a hard landing. Yeah, now I have. So these are just the things which are difficult to determine with the first-person perspective mod. Even though I probably should have, you know, seen his hands not grabbing the thing over there. Let's hope this doesn't make us fall. That is four strokes. Guessing we have to drop down. That is inconvenient indeed. Huh, safe. What do you know? We're safe. And yeah. I'm guessing this is a running jump sort of thing. Safe again. I'm getting a little too lucky in this game. It's making me nervous now. And this, I think, is the part where we need to drop off the ledge gently, does it? So that we can proceed further. I just realized that I'm gonna have to do a lot of editing in this video. But at any rate, it's going well thus far. And we shall take what is offered to us. Just look at the view. Just look at the gorgeous view. Huh. Who knew Georgia could look so beautiful? I wonder if these are the Alps or the Urals. I'm guessing these are the Urals, because I think the Alps are more towards Germany and Switzerland. But at any rate, or maybe they're in the same range, who knows. Let me just go ahead and make another save here. And I do believe that I ask that same question every single time that I play the game. Let me just bring out the stick. I've only got one sticky shocker, that is inconvenient. Oh my. But anyway.
Why don't you clean up after your dogs? Who is that? Get that damn spotlight out of my eyes, you filthy sniper! Aftandil, Bendry, keep the chit-chat off the airwaves. Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Yeah. So my plan of attack is to attack that sniper over there.
Ugh.
I find it funny how the light keeps moving, but all of a sudden these dogs are no longer hostile. Now this will let me know if this mission is alarm sensitive or not. What you gonna do? What you gonna do about it? Do you want me to shoot you? I would rather not. Sorry, pup. I'll need to shoot you. You are hostile to me. And we cannot have that. So, since we already had an alarm, I don't think this mission is alarm sensitive, per se. Okay, now who's shooting me? That's what I want to know. I see. So somehow this guy got to know where I was. Can you like show yourself, please? Anybody else? No? I'm gonna take that as a sign that I can move on with my life. Let me see if I need to take this guy out. If there still is a guy here. Because if he isn't, then we'll have to... Yeah, there isn't. I guess we just need to go over into this area, this courtyard right here, and get the door key from him. Should we shoot this light out? I think we should. But that did not help us any. Anyway, yeah. We're looking for the satchel here, and this body might as well be shifted to the shadows. Yeah, here's a better spot. I've always wanted to try going into this tower up there. Let me try, quickly. So, of course, I can't. I have seen people, you know, climbing about up there. I don't know how you do it, but apparently there's a way to do it. But anyway, these pipes are things which you can use to get the loose track of the dogs when they're following you. They won't be able to, you know, follow you, but they'll like sort of keep sniffing. And I wonder if we can pick this lock. I mean, it is incredibly shiny. It makes me wonder if you can just break it off. I'm guessing not. Hardly anything to guess about there, but you get the point. So the first time around that I came into this area, I went over to that side, then I came over to this side. And while I was running, going there, was the time when I realized that you actually have to go here. I mean, they have really done a good job of keeping this path concealed. It is borderline trollish if you ask me, but who's asking me? And might as well shoot this guy. Sorry, Nikoladze Scott. And the keypad code is 2126. 2126. Cool. Let's take these lights out as well, so that you cannot be in the shadows. Ah, you're in the shadows now, aren't you? Yes, that's a good boy. No satchels for me? Of course not. Anyway, saving it. We did not have to knock this guy out. I mean, we could have done it without knocking this guy out, but I'm thinking since it's a first person tactical shooter mod anyway, might as well just shoot away. We do have a first aid kit here. I really like how the music picks up here. Let me just go ahead and make another save. Now, this door is open and there's something on the desk here. Is that another medkit? It is. Ah, medkit's my best friend. So, typically...
A fresh kill! One of ours!
Fear. You know, I'm sort of nervous that I might have to... restart this mission all over again. Because of how many alarms I've been triggering thus far. And if it is the case, then I will. But I don't want to start this mission for no reason, you know? Three people. Oh, I'm guessing it was the corpse of the dog. That was the only one that was not in the shadows. So four guards at this point in time, at this stage, they really want you to sneak by this area. They do not want you to... I mean, it's fine, you can move in front of this guard. He's not gonna do much. He's usually not even looking at your general direction. Yes, that's it. Are you moving away? Good man. Look away. I do not have a disposable pick, so I think I'm gonna have to use my cunning for this one. Or unless the door is open. Yes, it is. How convenient for us. So yeah. Gotta admit, the music does make things super tense. And I don't have to kill everybody that I am killing, but it just sort of feels nice with the first person mod. As you can see, there are lasers all around, so like the first three steps have lasers, and there's like a laser gate up there, so the only way through is to grab onto this ledge here and just look at how pretty that looks. I can't speak through there. Actually, I can't speak in it. Interesting. Can Sam not climb up? I'm guessing not. Well, what we need to do is get up close to this and jump up. Now, if Sam was only a little bit more acrobatic, he could have pulled that off without a hitch. Like, he could have just climbed up over there. Anyway, moving on. The next section might be a little tricky.
Those aren't palace guards. Some kind of special forces.
Georgian elite. Probably Kristavi's men. Which would suggest Nikoladze's locals.
Does that affect my game?
No. Find those interrogation files. And Kristavi's men aren't going to be much friendlier than Nikoladze's. You're authorized for lethal force.
Cool. So let me just go ahead and fix it here. I could probably cross... I could have crossed the stair right now when the guy on the right is not looking, but yeah, I sort of refrained from doing that. I know I should not have. Now the thing is, we can just eliminate them. We don't need to be like, you know, super tactical. So this guy gets protected because of the rail. Anybody else that would like a piece of me? Well, considering everything that went relatively well. Relatively very well. Now to take the lights out. Because we like shadows, don't we? That should be enough, but we also have to take care of these guys down there. I also like how there's a sound at the end of the clip when you actually need to reload. There's like a subtle sound which cues you into it. So yeah, well, that was easy. Thank you. I'm hoping nobody else finds a body. Those guys seem to be in the perfect shadows. Like, perfectly in the shadows. And actually, there was a light switcher, wasn't there? Yeah. That we could have just done that and saved ourselves a whole lot of bullets. Anyway. Okay, that did not go as planned. Not at all. Actually, I do not want to pick up this body. Can I not? Yes, thank you. Anybody else want a piece of me? That one. And I'm guessing these guys are in almost in the shadows. Yeah, they should be in the shadows now. Now what I'm lacking are some 5.56 rounds. And I've always been curious what's down there, so let me just go ahead and check. Quick save. Actually, let me just make a proper save. I wonder if this is like another way into Gustavi's office. This door is barred off. And what about this door? Oh, we have a medkit here. How nice of them. Nothing else? That's good. That's good to know. Oh yeah, that's where we came in from. I was like, that's probably going to be another area. But I'm guessing there's something in here as well. Nope, nothing here. So all of these extra areas, I mean, while they do add to the realism of the game, they sort of... Oh, this is actually there. Somewhere. Data stick, of course. Well, might as well go ahead and read it. Okay, there are too many data sticks. Yeah, because I was arranged to allow Nikoladze into the presidential palace. It will happen tonight. Shortly after midnight, Nikoladze is giving Gustavi a sizable sum of money along with some near priceless oil drilling data from the Caspian in exchange for Gustavi letting Nikoladze retrieve the Ark from the palace unmolested. Nikoladze claimed that the Ark is a dirty bomb, but Gustavi has learned different. I'm betting he won't let Nikoladze walk out of the palace with the Ark in hand. Hard to say. My advice: keep your head low around midnight tonight, Kitty. So they were already in on the attack. I mean, they were suspecting it, not they weren't in. And this door is locked as well. Huh. Now, the problem is this camera that we're going towards is bulletproof, as you guys can see. So what we need to do is be careful. I mean, we can avoid it altogether if we time it right, but if we don't, we need to be careful not to, you know, get seen, because this camera is pretty good at doing that. Open the door. Oh, I need to pick it. Of course I do. Really, it's a 6-number lock. So I'm guessing that the one in Galena Tech wasn't the only one in the game. And this level now. Yeah, I'm crouching. Another thing which is pretty difficult to detect. Yeah, that was a fail. I'm guessing I need to get closer to it. Let's hope that I don't trigger it accidentally.
President Gustavi, sir, is that you? Nikoladze and his men are almost at the library. We are continuing to hold.
Anybody else? Nah, I'm guessing I killed everybody else. But I do need to get you into the shadows nonetheless. I wonder why the music is picking up again. I hope this would be a good position for you. And let me just go ahead and take out these two lights for insurance. Do you have a satchel? Yes, you do. Does it give me anything? No, it does not. And yeah, we just need to use this computer now.
I hate this kind of thing.
What do you have?
Interrogation, torture, and... Oh, Christ!
What?
The Ark is a SATM.
A what?
A special atomic demolition munition.
You mean a nuclear suitcase bomb.
Yeah. I'll get back to you.
Now, here's the thing. Lambert says he does not like that kind of thing.
The Ark is the mission, Fisher. Get it. It's in a safe inside a vault in the library, locked by scanner to Nikoladze's retina.
So I'm going to need Nikoladze alive to get the Ark.
That's right.
Oh, unfortunate. Actually, not unfortunate. No, Lambert says that he does not like torture, but then again, of course, I mean... He had to do what he had to do, but in either case, he does get to Hootie Torture, doesn't he? Yeah. I'm guessing it does not matter at this point, because every guard in this area has been totally wrecked.
That's our limit. One more alarm and I'm aborting the mission.
Ouch. That is very unfortunate. Now, I've got two choices at this point. Either keep playing with these restrictions, or... restart the mission. And I'm gonna keep playing with this mission. That was honestly my mistake. Maybe I should have reloaded from that point on. But yeah, I did not. I decided to keep playing. Or maybe, I mean, there's still time. I haven't moved on long enough. I'm contemplating reloading from that point. Because, I mean, we are going to be heading into a full-fledged shootout anyway. Doesn't make sense to play it safe, you know? Nobody's coming. Might as well make a break for it. And take this light out. Yeah, now we're in the shadows. Not that I needed to do that, because the next section is going to load in the next section anyway. Just look at how pretty this game looks. All these people dead. These are, I'm guessing, the presidential guards.
Reach the library. Nikoladze is inside. Everybody at alert. We are retrieving the Ark. Be ready to get out of here.
66768. So, I'm either gonna have to be like super careful about the next area or... Did you see something? I'm just gonna go ahead and risk it, a shootout at this point. I mean, these guys are far apart enough to not realize when somebody's gonna, like, somebody's getting it. I'm guessing that's that. The mission is not over yet. And I've got a frag grenade.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
I'm just gonna go ahead and quick save from this point onwards. This guy is in the shadows. Time to put that guy in the shadows as well. Just so that Lambert does not have any problems with anything. That was a little sloppy, I'll admit it. It could have been done far better. And I've honestly seen some people exploit a glitch. Where you can essentially... trying this again. I, for whatever reason, thought that this section is going to be easier with this mod. But I could not have been more wrong. Actually, I'll save that for the basement.
We have an intruder! Some kind of American commando. Get Nikolai into the vault, keep his head down until we take care of this.
The biggest problem being how... Are you dead? Anybody else? Oof, that was close. I mean, oof, I do not have any more health kits, like, at all. And I would really appreciate some, to be honest. Because I don't know how I'm gonna survive the next shootout at this rate. Are there any medikits here? Oh yeah, I've got one right here. That's better. Not the best, but it is better. So basically the glitch is, once you meet Nikoladze downstairs, you can just click on this, you know, elevator button to go upstairs, and you can actually go into Nikoladze's room to kill him. Sort of overkill, exploiting game mechanics, but I don't really mind, to be honest. So this section was actually more difficult than I anticipated it to be, and I'm guessing that it was primarily because of how they always knew where I'm going to be, even amongst the shadows. So yeah, I'm hoping you have another medical kit. Data stick, of course not. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my. That's a pretty bloody transcript. Huh. At any rate, we're just gonna have to make do with this at this point. I mean, this is the best I've got, because I feel like it was actually easier to pull this off in the third-person mod.
We need aid! They turned on us! Kristami's men have opened fire! We need back!
Did you kill him?
My God! Who are you? Who's there? Show yourself!
I just did. Come on, then. Now, this is the part where it gets pretty messy. And I, at least, would like to have all the lights out. In this area, anyway. Is that? Yes, that is an indestructible light. Huh, well, I guess... Then again, it doesn't really matter, does it? Because they sort of take care of the lights for you anyway. Well, here goes nothing. This is gonna be rough.
Tell me about the Ark.
Let me walk away. I can make you rich.
I know what it is. I want to know where it came from.
This gets you nowhere.
What are you going to do with it?
With what?
The Ark. Where are you going to detonate it?
Kill me, or let me go. What you're doing now is hopeless.
Tell me about the Ark.
This is puerile. I'll say no more.
Okay. So I'm guessing this is the only way now? Quick saving for luck, because I'm gonna need it. I've only got like half my health.
Nobody move! Hands in the air! Nobody move! Nobody move!
No, I did not see fishes. Swipe it up.
Come by Nikoladze.
Ouch.
And who is your friend? An American?
Ask him.
You will give us the Ark.
I am not God.
You will give us the Ark.
I honestly don't know what you are speaking of.
Kristavi knows. It is a nuclear suitcase bomb. And he knows you have it.
Clever man. Does he know that it is already in America?
What?
The Ark is not here.
Keep talking.
The only thing in this vault is the activation key. The bomb itself is in America. If Christophe guarantees my freedom, I'll tell him where to find the Ark.
Give us the activation key.
This spy has the key, this American. You'll have to take it from him. I can give you the location, but only on the condition of my safety and freedom.
Agreed. You two, escort Mr. Nikoladze out of the library. You, who are you?
So apparently if you shoot the helmets...
Don't talk, Fisher. We're arranging for a blackout in 5 seconds. Make the most of it.
So apparently if you shoot the helmets, it doesn't
give us
kill
the
them.
Key to the Ark. You can hand it to me, or I can take it from your corpse. You have 5 seconds to decide. 4 seconds. 3, 2...
Who did that?
I think not.
Show yourself.
Anybody else? I'm guessing there's one near the doorway over there. Not as much. I'm just gonna try and catch this angle. Yeah. Oof. That took me a few tries. Data stick, of course. Use the computer. Gain another data stick, perhaps. Another data stick. And nobody else has a satchel that I can utilize. So, since that was a pretty difficult part, I'm just gonna go ahead and save now.
Bishop, we can't let Nikoladze walk away.
You think he really knows where the Ark is?
Yes. We can't let him live with that information.
An intruder, an American, a spy is loose in the building. All troops to full alert.
I just wish I had a medikit, you know? So if you want to avoid dealing with these guards, right after this cutscene, you can go to the elevator and you can use it to go back up. But I want to make my life a little difficult. I like to live on the edge. So, yeah. I'm just gonna utilize this opportunity to shoot some guards in the face. So here's the thing, you need to shoot them in the face, because if you don't, the helmets will stop your bullets. Which is rather disconcerting for, you know. I find it a little unrealistic in the aspect that you can't exactly stop 5-5-6 rounds with a Kevlar helmet. But yeah, there you go. These people are doing just that. These people are shielded right now from my bullets, which I dislike. Maybe I need to get upstairs.
There was something there. Maybe it was nothing.
Yeah, maybe it was nothing. No need to, you know, get too close. No, I'm in a dilemma right here. Yeah. I'm guessing the alarms parameter isn't selective. Because if it is, then... Well, we're done for. I guess not exactly, because of course I can, like always.
The American is carrying intelligence vital to the safety of our nation. His capture or death is our highest imperative.
And where's this guy? Ah, yes, right here. I ran out of bullets. It's a good thing I didn't have just like one bullet in the chamber, because that would have sucked. And here's a sincere hope that... this is all we have to do. Okay, cool. Now, the thing is, there is 5.56 ammo right here, and I intend to pick it up.
Let me be as clear as possible. Snipe Nikoladze from there. Do it now, don't miss. You probably won't get a second chance at this.
If you say so, I'm hoping that's Nikoladze.
Sharp work, Fisher. It's time to get scarce. That data you're carrying is the last of it.
The last of what?
Nikoladze's threat against the U.S. Highest priority right now is keeping what you're carrying out of enemy hands. The Osprey's waiting.
Of course. Let me just...
Shot fired!
As you can see, this is pretty sensitive an area.
What's Kristavi's status? Cover President Kristavi! Get the President to a secure location!
Search for hostiles!
Assassin in the palace! I need all men!
We'll find you!
Direct order from President Kristavi. Find the assassin. Don't let the shooter leave the palace. Lethal force. The assassin is top priority. Where's Nikoladze? Who's covering Nikoladze?
Unconfirmed report that Nikoladze has been shot.
Nikoladze is dead. Repeat, Nikoladze is down. Find the assassin!
And all it took for all this chaos was just one bullet.
The American spy. He must be captured or killed at any cost.
Now, there are people down there, being the reason that I chose this path. And we can exit this path quite stealthily. There's no real call to action right here. But, like I said, I like making my life difficult. So, I'm gonna go ahead and find a good vantage point so that I can take both of these guys out. Or I could just toy with them. So how is it that these guys can manage to see me all the time?
Everybody down! Who is that? He's not breathing! Watch it!
Yes, come on. Of course. And that's that for you. And finally my plan works to flawless execution. Well, I wouldn't exactly call it flawless because I had to retry this section quite a lot, but it doesn't matter. It's the end of the level and this is it. This is literally it for this. There's like a certain delay between... Georgian Presidential Palace, Tbilisi, Georgia, November 13, 2004, 0129 hours. Intelligence gained from the Georgian Presidential Palace identified the ARC as a special atomic munitions device, or a SATM, which is actually quite close to Saddam. Huh, who knows? Especially the way the Americans pronounce Saddam. Anyway, the fact that it was already in place a short distance from Washington, D.C., made Nikoladze a clear threat to the safety of the American people. In accordance with the Fifth Freedom, that threat was neutralized. So yeah, that's that. I mean, we went in, we did like a full sweep of the entire area, and yeah, hopefully it wasn't too boring a mission. That being said, in the canonical storyline, Mars is still alive, so the information warfare threat and, you know, the Georgian Information Crisis 2.0 is still an impending threat to US security. But at any rate, that's this for this mission. Let's see what the NCMX have to show us.
An 8-story apartment building and surrounding 4 blocks in Hope Gate, Maryland, were evacuated today by the National Guard. Authorities cited a gas leak as the reason for the evacuation, stressing that today's events had no relation whatsoever to Combine Nikoladze or the Georgian information crisis. Hope Gate, less than half an hour from downtown Washington, D.C., will, since the recovery and confirmed identity of President Combine Nikoladze's corpse 5 days ago. Palace guards fatally shot President Nikoladze in the midst of what appears to have been an attempted ousting of acting President Varlam Krastavi. In a press conference this morning, U.S. President Bowers lauded the American people for their courage.
We were injured, we stumbled, but we did not fall. The world knows no hardship or terror that American tenacity cannot overcome. The world knows no problem that American ingenuity cannot solve. And so I extend my deepest admiration to every U.S. citizen of the world, to every civilian and every soldier standing firm against the terror and tyrannies of wicked men. History will not forget your resolve. History will not forget your resolve.
Dad, what's going on? You haven't laughed since the Reagan administration.
It's nothing. Forget about it.
We have kept the bright flame of American freedom burning throughout the world. May God clear our vision and strengthen our minds for the work to come. And may God bless America.
You're not leaving again, are you, Dad?
Hello, Lambert.
So there's some background music right now, which I will definitely be editing out, otherwise I'll lose my, you know, monetization. Not that I have any monetization, but I will lose whatever I do have as well, in the future, that is. So yeah, you know, if there's any money, I would rather make these videos free rather than let the money go to some big publisher. I mean, the money doesn't even go to the artist, it just goes to publishers. So yeah, anyway, I digress. The thing is that I want to say is, it's funny how Sam was laughing, you know, at how your resolve will not be forgotten, but his name is nowhere to be found in the history books for resolving all of these crises and conflicts. I guess it's just a thankless job that he does, Sam Fisher. He really is. That's that for this mission. I'm guessing the call from Lambert sort of ties into how Sam is then recruited into going after Philippe Mass, but yeah, that's that. So that. So this mission was good. This mission was actually difficult, pretty difficult. I tried. I had to retry a lot of sections, and it was primarily because I'm guessing that the developers wanted us to really focus on stealth for this mission instead of shootouts, except for in the place that they wanted us to engage in shootouts, because the enemies had pinpoint accuracy. I mean, if they would fire all four bullets would hit me and kill me instantaneously. And to further add to the problems, the helmeted enemies, the night visions, yeah, they actually have night vision gear in this game, which isn't always on, but they turn it on whenever the lights go out, and their helmets, they are bulletproof, so you need to aim for the face if you want a headshot. And to further add to the troubles, I was dying a lot. Let's just say I was dying a lot and leave it at that. So anyway, this was it for today. I will be following this up with three more missions, and until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings. Looking back to playing the Daggerfall mode.